I spent an hour every night on a clock on a show on Eastern Time that was just total BS. Like, that doesn't bother you? I mean, there was one, I think it was Ben. One story we had to come back the next day. We screwed up, I get out of heaven. Oh, I sent it 15 miles before because I'm going to show up. I was sure. I was very suspect about the story. Going to Cattery. And I said to my wife, there's no way she's showing up. I'll bet my right arm. You know, of course, she showed up. For the next week, I apologized profusely every day to my audience. And for days, I'm like, all right, enough. Like, you made your point, you apologize, move on. But I felt like I legitimately let them down and made a
show and let it be. to you, but I think the guy I work with on Facebook who helps me produce the content, he's like, just milk it as long as you can because you won't be here long.
You know, I will say that, you know, I think that not all these companies operate the same way. I think that Twitter is more of a threat to conservatives just by statistics than Facebook is. I think that, I've said before, I think that Zuckerberg seems to have an ideological commitment to the idea, at least, of people being able to get their opinion out there. It may be imperfectly applied by his company, but he at least is mouthing those words, and I think he actually does care about that stuff. I think that the precise opposite applies to people like Jack Dorsey, who brutally wants to shut down anybody who disagrees with him. I think there's some others. But, like, I think treating all social media identically is silly. And listen, I'd be a hypocrite if I sat here, and I think my page may be the most successful Facebook page in the United States. It would be really hypocritical for me to talk about being silenced on Facebook. But you can certainly see it on Twitter. I mean, on Twitter for sure. And the pressure is exorbitant. I mean, there are people who are out there every day trying to get you demonetized, getting people like Steven Crowder demonetized on YouTube. There are people out there every single day who are trying to pressure these companies into literally kicking off the pages, who are trying to get our advertisers to drop us because the advertisers have to be pressured. And that's a serious thing that the right has not done. And it's put me in the position of basically saying, listen, if you guys continue this, at a certain point, we're going to have to engage in mutually assured destruction. I don't want to do it. Like, I think that anybody should be able to advertise on whatever program they damn well please. And if Apple wants to advertise with Rachel Maddow, enjoy. But if it's going to come to the point where nobody's allowed to advertise on your show or advertise on my show, if they buy an ad on the Sunday special, then the leftists swarm, then there will come a point where the right is just going to say, listen, we'll do the exact same thing to your advertisers, and then nobody will have advertising revenue, and then we'll see how you like this.
Gosh, I could talk to you about this whole topic for hours, but a couple things.